this tutorial, you will learn how to create a linear and an exponential model using a scatter plot in Excel 2016. You should have already completed the steps in the scatter plot video and begin with a scatter plot already made. The next thing we will do is we will copy our scatter plot so that we can make both a linear and an exponential model chart. To create our linear model, we will first right-click on any of the points in our model and then select Add Trend Line. This brings up the Format Trend Line options. We're already defaulted to a linear model, which is what we would like, but we do want to display the equation on the chart as well as the R-squared value. We can drag this box to a more visible place. Now we can adjust our label. So we can click on the box with the data inside of it, label options, and set the category to number with 4 decimal places displayed and click enter. We can also increase the font size of our text by highlighting the text. This will automatically bring up a window where you can just increase the font size. Or we could accomplish this by clicking on Home and increasing it from this menu. We can repeat the same process to get an exponential model as well. So we'll go to our second constructed graph, right-click on one of the dots, Add Trend Line, and this time, instead of leaving this as a linear model, we will click on the exponential model option. We will still want to display the equation and the R-squared values on the chart. We can again drag our values down. We can update the text options by clicking on the box, going to Label Options, and selecting the last option, which will allow us to change our data to numbers and change the decimal places to 4. I will also go ahead and increase the font size here of my data. Excel defaults in exponential models to the format y equals a e to the kx. We typically like to use the format y equals a b to the x, so we can update this. We can change from this current format to the b format by taking e to the k in Excel. So we can begin this by e, which is the exp function in Excel. And then we can type in our value for k, which is 0.0599. This gives us our b value. We can just go in and edit our equation here in Excel and type in the value we got. So here we got 1.0617, and then we can close our parentheses. Now we have our function in the y equals a, b to the x format. Comparing our r squareds, they're both fairly low for our variables, but we see that the exponential model had a slightly better fit at 44%.